the controversy about androgens, estrogens, and all this metabolism. But the end result is people have problems with their skin, they have problems with their body weight, with their sexuality. So we created a situation where we could introduce a series of herbs, DHT block, we did Estro Block, we did Live Detox. So these are the categories that we've been working with.
I think they're great categories, but I think first we have to make a very blank and blunt statement. Mm-hmm. There's nothing wrong with having testosterone in our system.
Correct.
Both male and females require it. And all the nonsense about it causing cancer needs to be washed away. And I just want to appeal to the folks that are watching this to make them remember when they were in high school, which is when we are the healthiest, the testosterone levels were the highest, the estrogen levels were highest. There was no prostate cancer, there was no breast cancer. But we do need to also recognize the biochemical pathways that are associated with testosterone. So testosterone in the body will either remain as testosterone, or it may go to the pathway which leads to dihydrotestosterone. And so aptly you made the dihydrotestosterone block. That's where the skin can get a little oily if there's too much. Mm-hmm. You can get some acne. You get a little bit of hair that can lost with it if there's too much. So DHT block is talking to that pathway. Right. We have another pathway that the testosterone may go through, which is a pathway called the aromatase pathway. Mm-hmm. You don't have to memorize those things, but we should know that it can end up in being estrogen. Now, a certain amount of estrogen, we do need. We need estrogen to turn over our bones. Yeah, men too.
Men all need it.
But we don't need too much. And we want to make sure that the estrogen that is made goes into a healthy metabolic pathway. Now, what I mean by that is estrogen that goes into what we call the 2-hydroxy pathway is healthy. It's not going to cause any cell turnover that can lead to cancer like the other pathways, which we call 4-hydroxy and 16-hydroxy. Doesn't mean we don't need it, because bone turnover needs 16-hydroxy. We just don't want too much. And again, the product that you call Estroblock helps maintain that whatever testosterone is becoming estrogen will tend to go more towards the 2-hydroxy pathway.
The safer, the healthy pathway.
It is. And and one more point that I'll make on this, Nick, and you could say whatever you want because I'm monopolizing time. I like when I'm the boss. I'm older than you, so I can say what I want. But there is a point where you have to realize that these things, people are out there with these hormone clinics, doctors on every corner trying to give out testosterone. What they forget is there are metabolites. It's not the testosterone specifically that's causing these problems or estrogen. Mm. It's where does it go, the metabolites. Estroblock, DHT block is helping the situation to make sure that you've done your homework and made sure that testosterone remains as testosterone, and whatever becomes DHT or estrogen, it too is in a good pathway and the amount is good. DHT block, Estroblock, use them together. Makes sense.